Hi, this is David Wallerman with Arabesque Music, and today I'm going to show you how to start a new project in Guitar Pro 7.5. There are three different ways to start a new project in Guitar Pro 7.5. We can import a project in MIDI format, music, XML, ASCII, table edit, power tab. You can also start a project from one of the provided templates, or start from scratch, which is what we're gonna do here. Different tracks are available. We can do stringed instruments, orchestral instruments, drums. In this example, we're gonna create an electric guitar track. We're gonna go with a clean sound. We can now select the number of strings that we wanna use, going from 3 strings all the way up to 10 strings. We're gonna go with a traditional 6-string guitar here. Many tunings are available. We'll go with standard tuning. Notation will allow us to select the type of notation we wanna appear on the score that we're creating. This is for tablatures. Right now it's enabled. I can disable that if I want, but I'll keep it enabled. This is for standard notation. And this is for the slash notation, which is a rhythm notation. And then here I can select the type of sound I want to use on that track. Now because I selected a clean guitar here, these sounds are going to be based off of a clean guitar tone. And we also have access to a lot of different signature sounds, which are based on very popular songs from your favorite artists. Let's go with the Crazy Diamond song, which is based on a Pink Floyd tone. Before creating your track, you can always preview the sound that you selected by using this button here. Guitar Pro 7.5 is made of 4 different panels that surround your workspace. The first one is found on the left side. It's in the addition palette that you'll be able to modify your score by changing the key signature, the clef, time signature. You can also change the value of the notes you're going to enter in your track. You can also add some nuances in the way that your score is being played. And this is also where you can add all the different symbols that guitar players are used to reading. Pick scrapes, legato options, hammer-ons, pull-offs, taps, slaps, pops. You can also add some information as far as which fingers are being used. Flamenco players will be happy to discover the golpe sign as well. And of course, bends. A whole lot of different options are available here for the bends. You can modify the pitch you're bending to. You can also do some bends and releases, some pre-bends, pre-bend with an extra bend on top, pre-bend releases, all kinds of different options here. The next panel we're going to talk about is the inspector. The inspector is found on the right side. It's in the inspector that we can change the way that the tracks and the full score appears in Guitar Pro 7.5. Right now we're in the track view. This track displays a standard notation on the top and a tablature on the bottom. We're going to change that. We can disable the standard notation. Now only the tablature shows up. We can also add a slash rhythm notation on the top. I can also change the tuning of that track. Many different tunings are available, but you can also create your own custom tuning. I can add a capo, a partial capo. It's also in the inspector where you can change the preset that you're using on your track. And you can even configure the way that Guitar Pro is going to play that track by changing the playing style, pick, fingers, picking, bass slap. Now let's visit the song tab. This is where you can add a title to your song. You can add your name. Now here's a quick tip for those of you who want to completely change the appearance of your project. This can be done in the inspector. Make sure the song tab is selected. And we're going to go into the style sheet. Everything can be changed here. The page format, the size, the orientation. You want to add an indentation to the score? No problem, just click on this. You can change the font and the weight for any text available. That includes fret numbers, grace note fret numbers, texts. So if you're a Guitar Pro user and you're wondering if you can change the appearance of something in your score, the answer is most likely yes. And that answer is found in the style sheet. In addition to the style sheet, you can also use the design mode, which is found in the view design mode. This will allow you to change the way the bars appear. You can add or remove bars for each line of your score. The third panel we'll talk about is called the global view. That panel is found on the bottom of your score. In this example, we have a score with a lot of tracks. All those tracks can be managed and organized in the global view. The left side will display all the different tracks available in your project. You can mix each of these tracks, volume, pan, EQ. And then on the right side, you'll be able to see exactly when an instrument is being heard. This is a visual representation of the full song with different sections here on the bottom. And you can see, for example, that the vocals only come in at bar 13. Last but not least, the fourth panel is the toolbar. The toolbar is found on the top of your score. The toolbar will list the different play options. You can also change the instrument on which you are on by simply clicking on it. I can activate or deactivate the metronome. I can add a count in if I'd like to. I can loop a section that I select. And you can also pitch shift the whole score by increments of half steps above or half steps below. This option is very useful for players who tune a half step below, for example, and want to jam with a Guitar Pro project. All you need to do is change the pitch of the whole project. Now for our first track, we're going to add a piano, which is found under the orchestra instruments. Here's the acoustic piano. And because I'm a guitar player, I'm still going to show the tabs because I'm going to show you how we can enter non-stringed instruments with a tab. I'm going to create this track. Here's my piano. Now, adding notes in tablature is very easy. All you need to do is use the arrows of your keyboard to navigate strings and use your numpad to add the fret numbers. And for those of you who prefer entering notes on the fretboard, you can do so by going to View, Show Fretboard View, and you can just enter your notes directly on the fretboard. And this can even be done for drum tracks. Now, because drums are a little bit different in terms of tuning, you don't tune a drum set like you would a guitar or a keyboard, well, Guitar Pro 7.5 offers a great visual aid for that. And here you can see the different MIDI notes, which also correspond to the frets in Guitar Pro 7.5. So if I want to add a snare hit, that's 38. You can select any string, enter 38, and here's my snare. Another way to do this is simply to navigate with your arrows wherever you want to add one of these drum elements and click on the element you want to add. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you learned something new. If you have not yet discovered Guitar Pro 7.5, you should. There's a free demo available on the website. Check it out. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.